Oh shit, we're back already. Part three already. Oh shit. I was not prepared. Shit, shit, shit. Oh damn it, this is empty. Oh, this is empty as well. I need a drink. I need a drink. Let's continue. All right, we are now on chapter five. Chapter five, and this one is around 4 minutes. All right, this chapter's around 4 minutes, which means it'll take me around like fucking 11 minutes to read this whole chapter. Whatever. Let's continue. At the investigation in the baseball blah blah blah. At the investigation in the baseball field, the military has set up a detachment and at the baseball diamond, and a large black truck slowly pulls in, catching the attention of Major Bennington. I'm sorry, a Major Bennington or Major Paddington? Sorry, Paddington just struck into my mind. I can't be the only one who thinks that Bennington, Paddington. Okay, I'm wasting time. I need to keep doing this. A fold-out staircase is opens and sets up as Dr. Robotnik steps out of the truck, wearing heavy sunglasses, and a all black suit, with red trims on the inside. Oh, so he's pretty much dressed up like Peter Capaldi's doctor, and he makes his way over to Bennington along with his assistant, Agent Stone. Robotnik approaches the major and takes his glasses off as the major warily puts a hand on his sideman and holster in case he needs it. Are you in charge here? Dr. Robotnik asked. Yes, I am, Major Bennington replied. Nope, Robotnik denied. Major Bennington said. Wrong, Dr. Robotnik interrupted. Name, Major Bennington continued. I'm in charge, Dr. Robotnik interrupted. Excuse me. I'm not doing too good today. Is Major Bennington continued as he got frustrated at Robotnik's interruptions. Is me, Dr. Robotnik interrupted. Major Bennington continued. I'm in charge, Dr. Robotnik whispered. You've never seen anything like this before. This says I'm the top banana. In a world full of hungry little monkeys. Allow it to clarify. He makes a zipping noise. Okay, I have to do this. Zzz, zzz. There we go. In a squenchy rank hierarchy, based on a level of critical importance, is the disparity between us is too vast to qualify. Agent Stone, the doctor thinks you're basic. Agent Stone informed. On, I'm initiating a sweep sequence. Dr. Robotnik said. 10 miles in every direction should suffice. He glared back at for a bit. Is he still looking at me funny? Yes, he is, Agent Stone replied. I tell him to stop. I'll pull up his search history. Dr. Robotnik ordered. If you don't stop looking at the doctor, he'll take a closer look at Agent Stone said. To confuse Major. I'm not deaf, Major Benjamin interrupted. And tell his men and report to me now, Dr. Robotnik, it ordered Agent Stone. Blah 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 blah. Yes, that's in there. Excuse me, Major Benjamin in questioned. Listen, pal. Oh, I don't know if you realize. I'm sorry, Major. Dr. Robotnik apologized. What was your name again? Nobody cares! As Dr. Robotnik interrupted loudly, before or his expression changed to a mocker, to mockingly sad. Nobody cares. Listen, Major, nobody cares. Is you know why nobody cares who you are? Because nobody cares about your feeble accomplishments. And nobody cares how proud your mommy is that you're now reading at a third grade level. Have you finished Charlotte's Web yet? Spoiler alert, she dies in the end, and but she lives a big creepy egg sack. Sorry, I had to do it, man. It is fun impersonating Jim Carrey. I just want to walk up to Jim Carrey and just impersonate him right in front of his face. It's like, you know, like Jim Carrey, he's a legend. He better return for the third Sonic movie. He better return. And, my baby. No, wait, excuse me. He sees his drones flying around. Ah, my babies. Dr. Robotnik smiled. Oh, and look what came out of my egg sack. You know what I love about machines? He turns to face the drones. They do what they're told. They follow their programming, Dr. Robotnik informed. They don't need time off to get drunk and put the boat in the water. Is it just me, but every single time I see that scene and he says the word drunk, I swear he sounds like a donkey who goes, drunk! Okay, I can't do a donkey impersonation, but you know what I mean. He sounds a lot like a donkey when he says that. Oh, boy. He turns back at to face everyone on pointing at Bennington. And now, you do what you're told, Dr. Robotnik ordered. Stand over there on the edge of your personal abyss. He opens his arms. And watch my machines do your job. Oh. A disgruntled Bennington walks away. An agent Stone turns to face Robotnik. Oh yeah, Bennington, Major Bennington is played by a famous actor. And he's only in the movie for like 2 minutes. What a wonderful waste. You might as well have not even had him in there. Can you feel it, Stone? Dr. Robotnik asked. I can feel it, Doctor, Agent Stone replied. It's evolution, Stone, Dr. Robotnik said before he pressed pressed the buttons on his gloves and clenches his fist. It's evolution! There we go. The drones fly off into the distance. And in the flight, in the woods, the flying drone spread out in the woods, and one scans a nearby rock and finds a shoe print on it. Meanwhile, Robotnik's truck Dr. Robotnik is watching and controlling the operation on a giant in holographic screen. And Agent Stone enters. Agent Stone? Dr. Robotnik questioned. Doctor? Agent Stone greeted. Do you see anything useful in this image? Dr. Robotnik asked as he shows Agent Stone the image of a shoe print. Nothing at all, Doctor, Agent Stone replied. Of course you don't, Dr. Robotnik said. Your eyes weren't expertly trained to spot odd tracks by the Native American Shadow Wolves. Well, Robotnik presses some button. There, I can't speak. Robotnik presses some buttons on the control panel, and scoots back a little. As the image now shows what looks like an unusual foot. That's extraordinary, Agent Stone said. No, Dr. Robotnik disagreed. What's extraordinary is I've determined the exact height, weight, and spinal curvature of this creature, and my computer can't find a single match for it anywhere in Earth's animal kingdom. this blackout was not a terrorist attack. And that's no baby Bigfoot, he chuckled. This guy is something else entirely. The Vertol search unit, it's to the site of the footprint. And that's one small step for man, one giant leap for me. How long have you been reading? Okay, 9 minutes. Yeah, we can continue. We will continue. How long is this? Oh, this chapter's only 5 minutes, so only 1 minute longer. All right, yeah, we should be doing good here. All right, this is chapter 6. In the woods, the military and the drones are searching the area, while Sonic watches is from a distance. Okay, Sonic B, Eve, everything is fine. You played some baseball, got a little upset, lightning shot out your butt, and now they're coming for you. Sonic speeds back to his tree trunk, home. All right, Earth isn't safe anymore, or Sonic said. Time for plan B, Mushroomville. But I gotta take my stuff. Essential, or items only. He zips around on while packing. Toothbrush, toothpaste, is hair gel, nightlight, Sonic listed. Funny at, just half-eaten cantaloupe. My scented candle. My entire comic book collection. In beanbag chair. Can a beanbag chair fit in a backpack? No, of course not. No, of course not. That's stupid. Okay, what else? The rings! The rings, yes, of course! He wore a red backpack and holds the ring satchel. Now, am I the only one that thinks the backpack he wears is a reference to him wearing the backpack in the Sonic Saturday AM cartoon? Am I the only one that thinks that? Okay, it's just me. Okay, I'll moving on. Here we go. Sonic said, ring time, Mushroom Planet, here I come. As Sonic is about to toss the ring, and he sees drones flying overhead. Oh no, Sonic panicked. They're right outside. I gotta go someplace else. He takes one last look at his home. Goodbye, Cave, Sonic said sadly before he walks out. At the Wachowski residence, Paige continues to sketch a few ideas while her father is making things down on a map. Tom looks over and smiles at his daughter. What you doing, sweetie? He come up with ideas for a project, Paige replied nervously. Nice, let me have a look-see. That is literally what it said. Look-see. Okay. He saw a drawing of an epic fight between two superheroes with a planet on fire in the background. Looks good, Tom said. Okay, so two superheroes fighting. Okay, so is this a reference to Batman vs. Superman or Captain America Civil War? I think it should be a reference to Captain America Civil War because Batman vs. Superman was shit. Anyway, I don't know, Paige stated. Maybe it's a bit too much. Nah, artists can make whatever they want. Yeah, someone's going to take that out of context and use that as an excuse to make some really bad shit that could be illegal, and obviously no one should be doing that. Life lesson of the day, kids! Even though kids should not be watching my videos in the first place, because this channel is not for kids. But whatever. When we go over to the city, what kinds of art could I do? Paige asked. I'm a bit worried about my skills. And if I'll be good enough. Tom sits by her daughter. You mean his daughter? No, I'm not even joking. Like, literally, the author accidentally put Tom sits by her daughter. It's meant to be he. Like, there's probably a few women out there named Tom. But this is a Tom that is obviously a man. because it's based off a movie. Unless this is meant to be a gender bent version, which it clearly fucking isn't, because it was established earlier in the story that Tom is male. You fucked up, author! Sorry, I had to do that. Paige Evelyn Wachowski, you can do whatever you put your mind to. Tom said, just remember, you always got me and Mum to help you out. Oh, I did graffiti, Dad! You what?! sorry, I had to do that. I'm sorry, someone had to do that joke. If it wasn't going to be me, it was going to be some random asshole in the comments, alright? It was going to be someone in the comments. Someone had to make the joke. Yeah, I guess you're right, Paige agreed. As she smiled a bit, now, all you need is a bear hug, Tom added, as he gave Paige a playful hug. No, Dad, Paige laughed. I'm too big for that. Oh my god. Oh, here we go. The two who laughed before they heard a phone ring that made the separate. Tom's phone rings and he sees it is Maddie, who's calling and answers. Yeah. Paige looks back at her sketchbook and goes through her drawings. Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom greeted. Hey, Maddie replied. There we go. What you doing? Tom asked. I was just colouring with Jojo and Rachel. Oh, Maddie replied. That sounds half fun. Tom said. Exciting stuff here. We had a power outage. The whole town went dark. It was like a sign telling me to get out of Dodge. Wade must have lost his mind, Maddie said. Yeah, and he does not have much to lose, Tom added. How's your sister? Did she convince you to leave her yet? No, but she did tell me to check your phone for dating apps, Maddie replied. Oh yeah, if you don't know, there's this bitch in the Sonic movie where named Rachel that's trying to convince her sister to leave Tom for some reason. It's never explained. It's just there to pad out the runtime, really. Even though there were a bunch of deleted scenes that could have been used instead, including a really nice wholesome one, but that's neither here nor there. You can calm down, Johnny. You can calm down. Okay. The only apps on my phone are the ones that came with it, Tom said, and the Olive Garden. Because when you're there, Maddie quoted, your family, Tom finished. Paige rolled her eyes with a smile. Oh, but she had her father, she and her father heard a noise outside. What in the world? Paige muttered. No way, Tom said as he looks out the window to his garage. The raccoons are back, and they are in for a surprise. Tom opens the drawer. Dad! Paige scolded. Your surprise better not be my tranquilizer gun, and Maddie warned. They're just hungry. Also, that's for bears. Thank you, Mother. Does Tom have Maddie on speaker? Okay. Thank you, Mother, Paige said. Tom grabs a trank gun and cocks it. Good, Tom joked. Now I know it'll work. Tom! Oh, Maddie scolded. I'm kidding, Tom said. I'm just going to use it to scare them. Possibly to death. Love you, honey. Bye! Tom! Maddie said, but Tom hanged up. Tom hang up. Mum said it's for bears, Tom. Mum said it's for bears, Paige recalled. Well, I'm not going to shoot them, Tom assured, before he scoops a bit of cake off his finger and licks it before walking to the garage. God damn it, this fanfiction is really putting me in the mood for donuts and cake. I can really go for some donuts and cake. Like, oh my god. Like, I don't even like donuts, but it's putting me in the mood for some donuts and cake. Anyone want some donuts and cake? No? Okay, fine, I'll move on. Paige sighs before she gets up and follows him. Back at Rachel's residence, Maddie looks over at her sister. D-I-V-E-O-R-C-E, Rachel spelled. And before you guys ask, yes, I know she's saying divorce, alright? That's the reason why I said it like that is because that's how it's said in the movie, okay? Just letting you guys know. I know it spells divorce. Which, yeah, that's a good thing to put in a kid's film, isn't it? Yeah. Scene cuts to Tom's garage. It's day. Sonic has now climbed through the window and is inside Tom's garage, leaving dirt all over the workbench. Okay, I'm in. He got down from the workbench and onto the floor. With minimal damage to Donut Lord's properties, Sonic continued. He reached into the satchel and pulls out a ring. Okay, here we go. Didn't work out enough, but that's okay, Sonic assured himself. You're going to a safe world. A nice safe world filled only with mushrooms. Mushrooms that will be your only friends. That sounds awful. I can't do this. You have to do this. There's no other option. Oh, shit. He took a deep breath. All right. Sonic muttered. Sonic prepares to toss the ring when he hears the door or to the garage. I'm British, for fuck's sake. I need to say garage. I'm British. Sorry about that, people. Oh. He hears the garage door barging open and sees Tom pointing a tranquilizer gun and a flashlight. While looking around, Paige follows after her father in annoyance. SFPD, pending background check. Pause in the air! Tom alerted. Dad, they're just raccoons. They're not, Paige complained. Tom points the gun and flashlight at a stunned Sonic. Paige stops as she sees the blue hedgehog alien. Okay. Meow! There we go. Oh. This causes Tom and Paige to scream loudly, which makes Sonic scream as well. Oh, and Tom fires the trank gun and a dart hits Sonic in the leg. Ow! Sonic winced. Dude! Paige scolded at her father. As Sonic starts losing consciousness, he reads the words on Tom's shirt. San Francisco? Sonic questioned. And Sonic drops the ring and it opens up a portal to the top of the Transamerica building. In SF. In the middle of the floor, that causes Paige to back up in surprise, and a bewildered Tom watches while Sonic stumbles to the ground and drops the ring satchel through the portal, which lands on the roof of the building. The portal begins to close. No, Sonic said weakly. The portal all is now closed, leaving an unconscious Sonic on the ground, and Tom on still in shock at what he and his daughter just saw. What? Tom questioned. Paige looks over at her dad. What have you done? Paige asked. Okay. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Chapter 7. Should we continue? Okay, I've been recording for 24 minutes. How long is this? This is 11 minutes. Okay, yeah, we'll end right here. We'll end right here. See you guys later. Bye!